Right, Aki Karim here for BBTV. I'm here with Danny Morell, and I've actually just caught up with you by accident, really. You're out here getting some signal.
You know, saying thank you to everyone that's congratulated me. So,
is there a lot of people? Is the hotline blinging?
Yeah, you know the drill. No, a bit more breathing space as well. To be fair, it's packed in there, isn't it? So, it's nice to just, you know, find a bit of calm in everything that's just gone on.
But you're in there against where was he from? Bulgaria. Or
Bulgaria,
something?
Bulgaria, yes. No, Hungary. But Budapest, is that right?
Budapest, that's Hungary. That is. Yeah.
Yes, I'm right.
Steve Shafiq over here is nodding. You know your geography, do you?
Yes.
Yeah. Can you confirm that? Yeah.
Yes, I'm sure Budapest is in Hungary.
Yeah. So that all makes sense. I think he had 3-1-2, won by knockout. So he wanted a pushover. He definitely came to have a bit of a fight. So, you know, I did the business.
You've been out the ring 18 months, so yes. A little bit rusty in the first couple of rounds.
Yeah,
but you
got
the timing and you got closer to him, got him out of there.
It definitely felt like my debut tonight. When I had my first fight, it was in the lockdown, and I must have saw 4 people, including my opponent. It didn't really feel like a debut. I didn't even have any nerves. You know, it just felt like a bit of a sparring session, to be honest. But in there, when, you know, seeing my family to side and all the, you know, everything that I dreamt to happen, you know, having your pro debut, that's what happened tonight. So I did get the nerves in the first round, you know, now I've dealt with that. Boxing 18 months, I did feel a bit rusty, but, you know, got into my stride of things, went, you know, found southpaw, what best thing to do, boxed him a bit. You know, I'm normally a back foot fighter and he didn't want to come forward, so I had to start, you know, learning again, started going on my front foot a bit and got him out of there. So
I was actually sat watching it with your mate, Dave Allen.
Yes.
And, you know, he was just talking about the fact that, you know, he feels you're in the best place there over at Domingos.
Yes. Yep.
And it's been a good learning curve for you and development. Yep. And how's it all going over there?
So it's brilliant. I still pinch myself to this day thinking, you know, I'm training out the Ingles gym. You know, a special place. You know, I could go on and on. Everyone knows the Ingles gym. It's one of the most famous gyms in the world. But, you know, be training there and even, you know, that's the first time I've been Dom in the corner. You can just tell the experience straight away, you know, telling me to switch southpaw. Worked instantly. You know, telling me what to do and straight away you just... I just felt calm, you know, everything were relaxed, professional, down to everything. Even getting your gloves taped up and making sure that your shorts don't fall down by putting tape on it. Just little things like that just make you think you're in the right hands, you know, I'm in the perfect place. And it's only just the beginning for me, it's only my second fight. From here, we're only going up, it's just going to get better.
Yeah, so, you know, you're still young, very young,
yes,
aren't you?
Yes, 19, yes.
So you're very young.
Yeah.
The beginning of your journey.
Yeah.
Two fights in, you're signed with MTK.
Yeah.
You're with the Ingles.
Yeah. I'm in a perfect place.
You
know, I'm in the best place and, you know, it's all down to me. We had work and that's what I'll do. You know, I'm back in the gym on Monday. That's just what
back
it is.
Gym Monday, not having a week
No days off. I've got Kid Galahad to look up to, you know what I mean? He'll be running tonight, but I'll be up in the morning ready for training. You know, you can't mess about in this sport because that's where, you know, if I'm messing about, I could get caught up here, but, you know, I should be up here. So I can't, even in these fights, you can't leave a stone unturned. You know, this is my career. This is what I want to do for a living. So maximum effort. So everything I do is for boxing.
Yeah, now, of course, you're basically... in a gym which has had some massive success recently with Cal Brook in that Amir Khan fight.
Yep.
What was it like actually going into the gym the day after that fight or so to speak?
Unbelievable week. Obviously just being there, technically in my own camp for my own fight, as well as, you know, being in Kel's camp, it were, unfortunately I couldn't go over to Spain with him because I'm not jabbed, but, you know, the couple of weeks that they were back, just seeing Kel on the pad, seeing, you know, the big cameras, and, you know, it's good to get used to, really, because, you know, one day I'll be in his boots, so it's a good thing to watch, you know, acknowledge, see how he deals with things, because one day, you know, I'll be in that position.
Big shoes to fill, but you know what, everyone's got to have that ambition, haven't they? So how are you going to celebrate, and how are you going to sort of have this one, or, you know, you've got the weekend off, how are you going to celebrate the weekend?
Just relax a little bit, you know, it's done now, you know, enjoy it, soak it all in, because these are the things that next week I'll be, you know, wishing I didn't, you know, take advantage of. You know, seeing my family and friends is great, just going to relax now, back in the gym on Monday and start finding out when the next fight is.
Well done, mate. Enjoy.
Thank you very much.
You know, hope you have a good weekend celebration.
I will do. Thank you very much.